This is your one and only Firespark 81 with your daily dose of video goodness, and welcome back to some more Conan Exiles tips. Today, I'm going to show you all the different entrances to the volcano. Let's get to it. The first entrance we are taking a look at is kind of a hidden one. You may not just notice it right off the bat if you're not looking for it. If we take a look here, you can see it's kind of just like this crevice in the rocks. There's this tiny little cave entrance here. Let's take a look at it on the map. So if we take a look at it on the map, it's called the Highway, and you can see where it is in relation to the volcano. It's like over here in the corner. This is actually a pretty easy one to get to because there is a secret path. There's the passage here in the jungle, which brings you out, I think, somewhere right in here. So it'd be pretty easy to get to this location that way from the jungle. So yeah, it's this one. If you come through here and you'll hit a loading screen, and then it will pop you out over here right in front of the obelisk. So you can see the obelisk is right there. So for those of you who are looking to grab this obelisk, that's a pretty easy way to get it. Just head there to the old highway. This next entrance is out in the open and probably one of the first entrances you will find. So it is right here. It's called the Road of the Pilgrim, and it's a little bit more of a hike, but there is no load screen and there's a lot of obsidian and rock and stuff like that on the way. So you can see there's some obsidian there, and it's just like littered all throughout this pathway here. Run up this way. I'm going to take you all the way through the whole pathway so you can see it here. Some more obsidian there. And then you're going to run up here, and you got a solid path that you can just follow. You can see it there, kind of just carved out. And then we run up this way, and right here we go. This is the entrance here, and then you can run up the stairs here, and then it just leads deeper and deeper into the volcano. You can actually start fighting some thralls and stuff on your way there. So pretty much all there is to that one. No load screen or anything like that for that one. Just a nice smooth path. This next one is another one that you may have stumbled on if you're just running around the outside of the volcano in the cold section, and it is right here. It is the Hidden Highway. So you can see right here where I'm standing at, and I'm going to run you up this one too. This one is also another path, so there is no loading screen or anything like that. Just a nice smooth path right up into the mouth of the volcano. Well, not the mouth of the volcano, but right up into the volcano. So you got just a tiny bit of climbing to do there. And then a little bit of scorpion action going on. There's also some obsidian around this area and some golden lotus as well. But then the path leads around this way here and up into some more volcano action that way. And then if we come back around, you can actually make the jump here. So there's a path here, but you should, without any type of speed or anything like that, be able to make that jump there right off the edge, and that kind of just puts you over in this area so you can just explore around this area a little more. There's a lot of different areas like that in here where you can jump, and it leads to another pathway. So you can see that there's a path here that leads deeper into the volcano as well. The entrance you see behind me is a little more involved than some of the other ones, but it still works nonetheless. Let's take a look at its location on the map. So it is right here. It is called Dragon Mouth, and that's probably because it looks like a giant mouth. So this one is a combination of load screens and pathways. So you run into it, you hit a load screen. Then once you are inside, you're going to run down the pathway here, and you got like a little transition pathway. Don't run too fast or you will run into some lava. You're going to run up the pathway here, past some lava falls. Look at this. This is actually a pretty gorgeous area in here. I love the way the lava looks and how it's just like flowing down. Anyway, you're going to run across a little bridge like so, and then you're going to run into another load screen. After that load screen, it's going to spit you out into the volcano, and this one actually brings you the closest to the portal there that leads you to the volcano forge. So if we just come down this pathway here, and then you have this little narrow path here. You just run down this. Now, you're going to have to be very careful, and this is not, none of this volcano stuff is going to be easy, so this is all endgame stuff, but I'm showing you anyway, because so, you know, you got to be in the know when you do get the endgame. Anyway, you're going to jump up this here, do a little climb in action, and there you go. There's your entrance to the portal. You jump, just jump into that. That spits you out there at the forge. All right, Let's take a look at the last location. The last location behind me is one that I have shown before in previous videos. This is a really great one if you need to farm demon blood. So if we take a look here at the map, it is called The Flow. So we'll just go through here and I'll show you what this one looks like. This is another load screen. And then it spits you out on the other side, and then you can just run down this way here. And through this path, just follow this path along, and you're gonna need your sandstorm mask because you will hit noxious fumes. I'm in god mode right now for tutorial purposes, so we're just going to ignore that. And you can run through that little patch there, and that brings you out on this bridge here. And so whole location here is great for farming demon blood. All right, let's do a quick recap of the locations we've learned today. So first off, we have the highway, which is located right here. Next up, we have Road of the Pilgrim, which is right here. It actually starts right down in here, just kind of zigzags its way up there. Then we have the Hidden Highway, which starts right about like right here. And then we have the Dragon Mouth. And last but not least, we have the Flow. All right, that's it for this video. If you like what you saw, consider hitting that sub button. I want to give a big thank you to my Patreons for making this episode possible. You all are absolutely amazing people. If you'd like to join my elite crew of Patreons, please check out the link in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment down below. Let me know what you thought. If you're shy, you don't like to comment, just hit that thumbs up button and show your support. Until next time, thanks for watching.